Yeah, I spoke to the our doctor just before coming to here, so he said he's fine. He hasn't trained a great deal since Everton. Just felt a little knock on his knee, and so as a precaution, I didn't want to risk it. We could have maybe let him play on and run on, but I didn't want to put the risk in that for him and for the team. So, but he said he'd be fine. Yeah. I don't know.
Brendan, big ovation at the end there between you and the Leicester fans. The first say this season so far has been like a tale of two halves, and what do you put down as the main factor that's sort of seen the turnaround in form?
I think it's the... Obviously, it's what, 15 games now we've played. And actually, the first seven games, you know, those that have watched us, we'd actually played well, but not consistently enough in them, which meant then our results weren't so good. And then we had some awful performances. I think after Bournemouth, we then got together because we'd played well in that game and then end up conceding two per goals. And then we spent the next week just purely working on our defensive principles, how we defend, how we press, and then just really reinforcing a lot of those principles, because we played some great football, but you can't win games unless you defend well. And so we really put that work in, and the players have been absolutely brilliant, you know, and their work, you know, they now, you know, we can play at home, we can play away, we know we can score goals, but there's a real resilience now there with the team. And if you look at a clean sheet record, you'll see that over the last eight games. But it's also a huge testament to the club, because the club have never ever wavered, which obviously gives confidence to people in general. So it's a huge testament to the board, the people actually work in the club, you know, because I said before, and people maybe looked at me, sometimes when a manager's under pressure and you're not getting the results, normally in this world, this is when betrayal kicks in and you feel it and you know it's there. As a manager, and most of you will know what I'm talking about when the side conversations kick in for a manager, but that was never the case at Leicester. Everyone was very supportive, and they all believed in the process, and I've said before, it was just time to work out the issues that we had over the summer and now, and then we get a rhythm back, and that's what's happened. So it's great. It's great for the supporters, because they've had a tough start, but now they're proud of their team. 3,000 supporters there today, and just thank them for the great support and staying with the team.
That moment at the end, the supporters went, and that must have felt pretty nice. It felt like all of them right behind you.
Well, didn't see any banners. They must be put in the shed last couple of days or last couple of weeks.
Danny Martin offside,
because obviously keeping Johnny out now, Johnny's back. Mm. It's something that we don't discuss very often. Danny Martin. No, he's been great. I think centre-halves, it's about the partnership rather than just one player, and those two combine really well. I think Johnny and White also, there's a good combination there, but it's only fair that he plays, because he's been absolutely brilliant. You know, you think away at Everton, we don't concede, away at Wolves and some of the other games, he looked really strong. And so as a unit and as a pair in particular, those two have been excellent. But it's great to have Johnny back, because he's a top player. But the two centre halves have been really, really important for any team. They need to be strong, and both of those guys have been that.
Brendan, as a follow-up to your answer, you mentioned the manager under pressure, sometimes betrayal may begin. In terms of your case and the club giving you a chance to turn that around, you show sometimes the benefit in giving managers more time as opposed to
Yeah, listen, I've said it before, it's just the nature of the game now, you know, from you guys, and there's much more media outlets, which then brings the pressure, and for managers, which then feeds into boardrooms, you know, but But I think it's something that hopefully my work here was evidence of what we'd done before. So when we did hit that sticky patch, because you do as a manager, there's, unless you're very, very fortunate, and even the fortunate ones with all the money, you're never going to, it's never always going to be in a forward trajectory. There's going to be moments where you have a blip, and then you have to, consolidate everything again and go again. And like I said, I'm very, very lucky here that, and fortunate that the owners have shown a belief since the first day I walked in and to bring me here. And they've let me get on with my work without pressure. I know I need to win games. And that's my job. And the club expected me and trusted me to do that. But it's a business now where managers, if they're not getting it, everyone wants change.
You know, West Ham right now also struggling with form. Do you reckon also Pat Moyes deserves time to turn
that around? Yeah, and absolutely. He's a top-class manager. You know, he's taken the club from where it was a few years ago. He's brought it into European football, which you'd never have thought that a few years ago from where they were. Obviously, a big turnaround in the summer in terms of players. So the adaptation takes a bit of time. You get a lot of new players coming into a new level. And plus, you've also got some senior players that are on the decline. You know, and that also happens. But David's a top-class manager who, you know, it'll be disappointing for him where he's at, but he'll go away and he'll use this time well and come back, and I've got absolutely no doubt he'll get them working again and getting them winning games. Pleasure. I don't know. Listen, we were bottom of the table there a few months ago, and there was a lot of negativity around it. I think, as always said, finish as high as we can. But let's see, we're only a few points off the top 10. And then if we can break through and show the level that we have been, hopefully the players come back from the World Cup safely. Hopefully we can then get some support and get some fresh faces in January. And then, like always, our ambition is to finish as high as we can. But we've had a fantastic last 8 games. The feeling and the mood is much better than where it was a few months back. And now we can look upwards. But it's all, you know, to unlock that success, it's not just about the talent, and I think we've shown that with that effort we can achieve whatever it is we want to. So but a lot of work to do.
Can you see any of the factors in this team that you've not seen in previous years where you've been excellent in these few away games that weren't previous seasons?
No, not really. I think, listen, a team that finishes fifth in the table, you've got to have certain characteristics. You've got to have resilience, you've got to have quality, you've got to have talent, and you've got to have a mentality. So if you finish fifth twice and eighth, then you have those characteristics. So, it's great that, you know, the players, the most important thing, we found our form again, we found our consistency, and coming away from home is important. But resilience and organisation was very, very good. And we take the 3 points.